Hello children, welcome to EVS revision class. Today we will revise unit 3. And whatever topics we will revise in this unit, please listen it carefully. And the revision worksheet which you have received, do it very attentively. All those questions are very important. So we have learned about layers of earth. How many layers of earth are there? There are 3 layers. One is the crust, mantle and core. Core has 2 parts. One is inner core and the second one is the outer core. Yes? Crust. The outermost layer of the earth is the crust. Okay? And its thickness is, it extends to about 30 kilometers to 50 kilometers under the soil and 6 kilometers to 15 kilometers under the ocean. Next is mantle. Most of the volume of the earth is in the mantle. Near the crust, it is very hot, but as we go deeper, it is hot liquid. Okay? Then comes the core. The core is the innermost layer of the earth and it is extremely hot and can be divided into 2 parts, outer core and the inner core. Next is rocks. Now the solid layer of the earth are made up of naturally occurring solids that are called rocks. Now how we were using rocks in prehistoric time? So in prehistoric time we were using hammer stone, and hammer stone was used to beat on surfaces. Then sharp stones were carved out from big stones and used to hunt or kill animals. And then flint stones were used to light fire and cook food. Monuments are also made up of rocks, like the Shor temple and the pyramids. They are all made up of rocks. Now in the modern time also we are using rocks. How? Now rocks are still used in construction, for producing energy and in day-to-day life. Now coal is a rock that is burnt in power plants to produce electricity. So which rock is burnt in power plant to produce electricity? That is coal. Now limestone is also another type of rock used to make cement. We use cement in building walls, and there are many other uses of rocks that you have learned. Yes? Now types of rocks. So igneous rocks. Now igneous rocks are divided into 2 types. One is intrusive and another one is extrusive. Okay? Intrusive rocks are formed inside the earth and extrusive rocks are formed outside the surface of the earth. Now intrusive rocks are formed when magma cools inside the earth, and extrusive rocks are formed when magma cools outside the earth due to volcanic eruption. Now what is the another name of intrusive rocks? That is plutonic. And what is the another name of extrusive rock? That is volcanic. Okay, so remember, intrusive another name is plutonic and extrusive another name is volcanic. Now size of crystals. Intrusive rocks have large crystals and extrusive rocks have small crystals. Rate of cooling. Now intrusive rocks, magma cools inside the earth, so the rate of cooling will be slow. So intrusive rocks rate of cooling is slow, and extrusive rocks cools outside the surface of the earth, so it cools faster. Now the example of intrusive rocks can be granite, and the example for extrusive rocks is basalt. Okay? Now sedimentary rocks. Now what happened? The tiny particles of rocks or dead plants or animals, with the help of wind and water, it comes in the sea and settle down at the bottom of the sea. Now these fragments of rocks sink to the bottom of the sea and form layers of sediments. With the time, these sediments keep getting pressed with more and more layers and turn into rocks. Rocks that is formed by this pressure together of sediments are sedimentary rocks. Okay, so those layers of rocks are coming and they are forming layers, and with the pressure what those layers change into rocks, and those rocks are known as sedimentary rocks. So the rocks which are made from sea creatures are sedimentary rocks. Okay, now two examples of sedimentary rocks are sandstone and limestone. The rock is used to construct building. Okay, sandstone is used to construct building, and the Lal Qila is in Delhi is made up of sandstone. So the Lal Qila, we all know that is made up of sandstone. Okay, and limestone is used to make cement, chalk and glass. Now comes to metamorphic rock. We have learned that igneous rocks are formed by cooling of magma, and sedimentary rocks are formed by pressure on fragments of rock. What happened when these rocks are under high pressure and heat at the same time? They do not melt, but they get converted into another type of rock, that is metamorphic rock. So when sedimentary rocks are under pressure and heat, they are changed into metamorphic rocks. Okay, so granite is an igneous rock that changes into gneiss, and gneiss is a metamorphic rock. And limestone is a sedimentary rock that changes into marble, and marble is a metamorphic rock. So two examples of metamorphic rocks can be gneiss and marble. Okay, so gneiss is used to make floor tiles and kitchen countertops, and marble is used to make buildings, and Taj Mahal is made up of marble. Okay, now rock cycle, like after day comes the night, after night again comes the day. Same way one more cycle is there, that is a rock cycle. It is a continuous process. Rock cycle never stops, but it is very hard to notice as it is very slow. Okay, so to understand the rock cycle, let's start with magma or the molten rocks from the mantle. Okay, when magma cools, it forms igneous rocks. We all know when magma cools, if it cools inside the earth, then it will be intrusive igneous rocks, and if it will cool outside the earth, then it will be extrusive igneous rock. So when magma cools, it forms igneous rocks. Igneous rocks slowly get eroded due to weathering by wind and water to form sediments. Okay, so sediments are formed, then these sediments settle down on the seabed and are pressed down under more and more layers to form sedimentary rocks. Then sedimentary rocks are under pressure inside the earth and form another type of rock, that is metamorphic rock. And then metamorphic rock again melts to form magma, thereby restarting the rock cycle. So first magma cools to form igneous rock, then igneous rocks slowly get eroded by due to weathering of water and wind to form sediments. Then those sediments settle down and form the layer, and those layers get converted into sedimentary rocks. Then sedimentary rocks are under pressure and heat, and then they are converted into metamorphic rock. And again metamorphic rock melts and make magma. So from magma, igneous rocks, then igneous rocks to sediments, then sediments to sedimentary rock, then sedimentary rocks to metamorphic rock, and again metamorphic rocks to magma, and then the cycle restarts. Okay, now minerals. Long ago, human being discovered that if rocks are ground or heated, they could be separated into small parts, which were pure forms. Okay, the physical property of color, strength and shine of these parts were always the same. These parts of rocks are called minerals. A rock can be made up of two or more minerals. Minerals have a consistent crystal structure and are naturally occurring. So minerals are naturally occurring. Human beings cannot make minerals. They are inorganic, so they are non-living and they are very solid. Okay, they are not liquid or gaseous, they are solid. Earlier times, minerals were used to make tools, or earlier like copper tools were made, then iron tools were made. In the modern time also, we used to use minerals for making fertilizers, dinnerware, cements. Yes? So, which is the most abundant mineral found on the earth? That is feldspar. Feldspar is the most abundant mineral which is found on the earth. And which is the second most abundant mineral found on earth? That is quartz. Okay? Now, properties of minerals. Properties of minerals are hardness, crystal forms, color, luster. Okay, these are the properties of minerals. Now, how we can judge the hardness of the minerals? That is through the Mohr scale. Okay, if Mohr will be the Mohr scale, that means the hardness will be more. And if the Mohr number is lesser, then it will be soft in nature. So, like you can open your SR11 in that chart is given. So, which is the hardest mineral? The hardest mineral is diamond because its Mohr number is 10. And which will be the softest mineral? That will be talc because its Mohr number is 1. Okay? So, higher the Mohr number, it will be harder. So, diamond has 10 Mohr scale number. So, it will be the hardest. So, diamond is the hardest mineral. Okay, so with this we have completed the revision of unit 3. Please revise this unit carefully, read the chapter again and the revision worksheet which I have provided to you. Try to solve it, and if you face any problem in solving that worksheet, you can just message me and ask your queries. Okay, prepare this unit very well. Okay, children, good luck for your exam.